Dear students of class 12th mathematics, assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I am Malik sir from higher secondary school Tharal Boys. Today our topic is given on integrals. We will give it its introduction like this: integration as an inverse process of differentiation. Integration is the inverse process of differentiation. Instead of differentiating a function, we are given the derivative of a function to find its primitive, that is the original function. Such a process is called integration or anti-differentiation. Let us consider the following examples. We know that first one, d by dx of derivative of sin x is equal to cos x. Second function, derivative of d by dx of 1 by 3 x cube is x square. Our third function of isolating d by dx of e raised power x is e raised power x. Then we observe that in first function, cos x is the derived function of sin x. Similarly, second and third, above x cube by 3 and e raised power x are the antiderivatives of or integrals of x square and e raised power x respectively. Also, we know that for any real number c treated as constant function, its derivative is 0. Hence, we can write first, second and third as follows: d by dx of sin x plus c is equal to cos x, because derivative of constant is always 0. Second, d by dx of x cube by 3 plus c is e raised x square is equal to x square, and d by dx of x e raised power x plus c is equal to e raised power x. So we introduce a new. Now we introduce a new symbol, namely this symbol, like this, fx dx, which will represent the entire class of antiderivatives, read as indefinite integral of f with respect to x. Symbolically, we may write integral fx dx equal to fx capital fx plus c. Notation given that dy by dx equal to f of x, then we write y equal to integral fx dx and read it as integral of f with respect to x. Here we read this integral of f of x with respect to x, or with, in short, we read it as integral of f with respect to x. There are some important results to remember, which are as follows. Number one, integral of x raised power n dx is always equal to x raised power n plus 1 whole divided by n plus 1 plus c, provided n is not equal to minus 1. Second result, 1 over x dx, integral of 1 over x dx is equal to log x plus c for all x belongs to e. Third result, integral of e raised power x dx is always equal to e raised power x plus c, where c is called a constant of integration for all x belongs to c. Third one, fourth result is sky, integral of sin x dx equal to minus cos x plus c for all x belongs to c. Or fifth result, integral of cos x equal to sin x plus c for all x belongs. Or chhata result is aisa, integral of x square x dx equal to tan x plus c, comma x should not be an odd multiple of pi by 2. Aur iska satma result hai, integral cos x square x is all equal to minus cot x plus c, x should not be an even multiple of pi by 2. Aur iska satma result hai, sec x tan x dx, integral of sec x tan x dx equal to sec x plus c for all x should not be an odd multiple of pi by 2. And iska 10th result hai, cosec x cot x dx is always equal to integral cosec x cot x is equal to minus cosec x plus c. X should not be an odd multiple of pi by 2. Aur iska 11th result hai, tan x integral of tan x dx equal to log cos x plus c. Or it is taken to be equal to as log of sec x plus c ki integration aayegi. X should not be an odd multiple of pi by 2. Aur iska 12th result hai, integral of cot x dx equal to log sin x plus c. X should not be an even multiple of pi by 2. And last result, 13th one, integral of sec x dx log of sec x plus tan x plus c. X should not be an odd multiple of pi by 2. That is the end of today's lesson. Thanks for listening.